not the one that was released exclusively on the Xbox, but this one is on both Xbox and PlayStation. They've added some new Devil Breakers for Nero. One specifically is the Punchline, which is really dope, and I want to show that off and show off some cool little tricks and shit with that. So I'm super excited for this Devil May Cry 5. Actually, there's actually some really interesting shit about V and his demons. So this is just a big breakdown of the tutorial, you know, Punchline, Overturn. We know about Overturn from the Xbox demo. But talking about V, it's really weird. Maybe it's possible, but his demons look and function a lot like the enemies and bosses from previous Devil May Cry, specifically Devil May Cry 1. In Devil May Cry 1, you had a beast called the Shadow, which is the name of one of his demons. And you had a boss called the Griffin, who had a weird, like, tri-beak mouth thing going on, which hit, and he uses lightning. He shoots lightning. That's a big thing. Griffin shoots lightning, and he's a bird who has a weird, kind of double-layer beak type of thing going on. Like, he has a weird beak design, just like the bird demon that V carries with him. He has like three beaks that come together. Yeah, we all know about this. This was in the demo originally. Okay, so yeah. I haven't played a Devil May Cry game like this in a minute, so a little rusty on the controls. But yeah, so two of his main enemies look like enemies from the first game. Especially the panther shadow looking creature. It moves and attacks just like the shadow creature from Devil May Cry 1. It has a giant move where it jumps into the air and is a big old spinning blade. It has a thing where it shoots the spikes out. What else have I seen it do? It does that thing where it turns into like it sticks to the ground and turns into a ball and shoots like a super long spike out. Yeah, we've seen that. Which okay, I'm actually gonna break away this one, because I want to use the Punchline one. Yeah. The Punchline one is really cool. Oh, there he is. I remember on the demo, there was one of these, money. Oh, get over there, bitch. Money creatures. Hey, stop running. Oh, yeah. Alright. So you got it attacks and moves just like the shadow creature from Devil May Cry 1. And then the little bird thing he has shoots lightning and has, that weird beak thing that Griffin had from Devil May Cry 1. Now, I can't remember if there's any enemies that resemble a golem. I don't remember any enemies that resembled a golem from Devil May Cry 1. But I remember there was like enemies like that in Devil May Cry 2. But I feel like it would mess up the flow of things if that was the case. Or maybe it could be something completely new. I'm not 100% sure. Cleaving Vanguard, Hellkainen. Now these guys these guys might not actually be from Devil May Cry 3, but they definitely. Okay, here we go. Yeah, this is the. Ah, damn, I fucked it up. Okay. Wait. Okay. You catch it. Okay. Cause you can ride it, as I was showing you. You're just gonna catch it in midair. Okay. You punch, let me punch. Dang it. Alright, let's just. Come on, let's. Alright, I got hold B. I'm stupid, I forgot. Alright, so you hold B, and then you can rally a rocket on it. Fuck, I keep fucking it up. I keep pressing that. Alright, let's try this one more time. So you jump in the air and hold B, and then you can attack with your flying rocket arm. Shit is sick. And then you just jump off. And it goes back to fucking people up. And you can still do your own thing. It's like high time. It's like round trip, but with a fist. And you can still use your grapple. Fuck them up. Like Punchline is by far my favorite. It's Punchline and it's the gerbil, the gyro, where you can like bounce around. Those two are currently my favorite. Fucking Punchline is awesome. Yeah, this one is pretty dope too. Do that. But I don't remember if Devil May Cry 1 had a golem type enemy. Or the golem could be Nightmare. Or it could be references to Nightmare from Devil May Cry 1, but I'm not sure. But this all is to accumulate up to, I think that V is related to Mundus. Maybe not his son, maybe someone who's a worshiper or something. I'm not really sure, but he definitely brings on Mundus's vibes, because he has a lot of like Devil May Cry 1 enemy themes. Like I said, the shadow, the griffin bird, and the griffin bird seems like to be like his closest, like, you know, because that one talks to him and shit. So you know, and in Devil May Cry 1, the griffin that that's the boss in Devil May Cry 1, he like actually like is scared of Mundus. Like he's like, you know, when you defeat him, you don't kill him. Mundus just kills him because he fails. You know, so it seems like he has a closer relationship with Mundus, unlike any of the other bosses you fight. Like, that's cool. Unlike the other bosses you fight, he seems like he actually like is close to Mundus. Or, you know, if in terms of service, you know, because Mundus, he's the only one Mundus kills out of all the bosses you fight. So, I'm feeling like this dude is trying to. Either V is trying to become Mundus, or he's like becoming a vessel for Mundus. Who knows? It's all burying. It really none of it holds much water. It's just some monsters resemble monsters from Devil May Cry 1. And it's not even to say that in Devil May Cry 1, Mundus was in control of the shadows. They kind of seemed just kind of to be around. But he was the most powerful demon at the time. So maybe he did control them. So, you know, like I said, we'll see in the game when the game comes out. But I got a strong feeling that V has some relation to Mundus, either as a worshiper or he's like kind of be his vessel, and he needs to stop Arisen from being a demon king and all this shit. And it would explain that one cutscene where you know, he's trying to kill Dante. Or he's, you know, stabbing Dante in the chest with his sword. You know, and he says, like, he says, this is all his fault. Or the reason I exist is because of you. Or some shit like that. So, I really think that him and Mundus have some type of relationship. Be it vessel or blood relation. Don't know what kind. Maybe a story will the story will tell. I guess I can talk about a little bit of Virgil stuff going about. Some people think Virgil is rising. I don't know about that. I don't think it's possible. But I think he could be working against Ryzen. I believe that. But I don't think he is Ryzen. And I definitely think he's in the game. Like, in the cutscene, Nero gets his arm ripped off, ends up with a double breaker. I definitely think that was Virgil in that cutscene. Like, only three people know how to use Yamato. Virgil, Dante and Nero, and I guess their father would count too, but he's supposed to be dead. It's crazy, it's just next month. Just, well, a little less than a month now. So this game drops. So on a demo that was on the Xbox, you actually couldn't use her. They didn't implement it yet, but in this one you can. You can buy a couple moves. The air hike and the round something attack for Nero, where he like spins in circles in the air. So skills. You can buy double breakers because she makes them. So for abilities, you got the air hike. That's like a trademark Devil May Cry move. The roulette spin, yeah, that move. Oh no, I'm too broke. I can't afford it. Exceed. Can't afford Exceed either. Purses. And then you can buy a bunch of arms or hands, but we don't have no need for that, so we'll just leave out with our one move, unfortunately. Maybe I can manage to collect 2,000 rubies before going down to fight the boss. Okay. I'm not even sure, but I swear I've seen somewhere that the demo allowed you to play as V, but I don't know how you do that. I don't even know if that's the case for the demo that like the public got. Maybe that's like a special demo that press got, and special people. So, I want to just talk about some of the Colossus said, the Goliath said, right quick. He talked about the blood. Now, we all know that Dante and Virgil carry the blood of Sparta. And in their, oh shit, I thought I could use my thing to get over them. And, ooh, fuck. I'm getting hit way more than I would like to. But yeah, so. Oh. Oh, shit. Oh, shit, damn it. Take this fist, motherfucker. Oh, if you get hit while I fly around, it breaks. Okay. So, we all know that Dante and Virgil are the blood sons of Sparta. Uh-oh. Oh, shit. This is not good. So, he's the blood, you know, they're blood sons of Sparta. But in the recently re-chronicling of Devil May Cry series, 2 now comes before 4, and Nero is counted as having the blood of Sparta. Because at the end they say descendants of Sparta, 2 descendants of Sparta, you know, protect the land. And, you know, unless, well, most people believe Nero's the son of Virgil, which I can buy. I can, you know, why else would he be able to be compatible with the, you know, be compatible with the, Yamato? You know, it's not like Virgil ever lost his arm at some point and then they attached it to, you know, a baby or whatever. So, he has to have some kind of relations to him and to some pedigree, right? Alright, let's fire it up. Uh-oh. What's he doing? Oh, fuck. Oh, fuck. Goddamn. Okay, so use on different tactics. Uh-oh. Oh, he's about to suck in right now. Yeah, he's on the sucking move. Don't want to get hit with that. Oh, shit! Oh, just barely escaping it. Oh, that was close. Definitely don't want to have to waste another arm just to escape that. And I was just out of range. What? I charged that thing up. Oh, okay, I think I... Okay. I see if I can get him down one more time before, I kill him. Nope. Oh, unfortunately. And that's the end, then I get ranked and all that stuff. But yeah, what I wanted to say is, I don't know if Capcom or, the creator of Devil May Cry confirmed that Nero was the son of Virgil, or it's just been a fan theory, but I feel like in this re-chronicling of Devil May Cry, they have in some way confirmed that Nero is related to Sparta, maybe a grandson, or maybe some way, inherited his blood in some kind of small portion. So that is the demo. I don't think there's anything else to show. I don't think there's I don't think there's anything else. Excuse me. You know, if there is another demo out there, I'll definitely go and check it out. But as far as I know, this is the only demo That's on PlayStation. I press continue, I don't think I'm going to be anything different. Okay, I didn't know that they can get broken while they're on the ground. I mean, it's crazy that Nico just kind of let her devil arms get left all around the floor. And I know she can make them. Yeah. The same old stuff, nothing new. So if something new does come up, you can bet that I'll cover it and make some videos on it. But I'm going to end it here. Oh, wait. Hold on. Okay. So you can buy... So if you keep playing through, you can eventually buy all the stuff. That's good. That's all fine and dandy and all. The shuffle. What's the shuffle? After a volume attack or backstep and rush forward and counter. Oh, a fast, powerful blow. Can I try it? I'm gonna try it. Oh yeah, you can't try it in the demo. Then you got the enemy step. Everybody knows the enemy step. That's when you jump on the enemy's head. Then the XC thing. That's the thing where you like turn on the motorcycle engine that's attached to Nero's sword, the Red Queen. That's a quick customization. I wonder how upgrades will work for the Dante and V. And it was just mission start, right? Yeah, I think it's just... After that, then it's just the same thing. I don't think it's anything different. It'd be nice if it was. Yeah, there's nothing different. That's breaking stuff. Yep. Well, I'm gonna call on this one. Hope you enjoyed it. Peace.